Hello, Blitz fans of all ages, it's me, Plumcastle, and this is the T32. Now, the T32 is honestly one of the best hold-down tier 8s in the entire game, which may actually come as a surprise to some of you, because you just don't see it that often in random battles. When you think of a good hold-down heavy tank in tier 8, you're probably thinking of something more like, say, Enemil 1 or 53 TP, you know, the tanks that we see game in and game out and see it all the time. That's not the case for the T32, it's just not seen very often, yet if we take one look at the armor, you can see it's definitely pretty up there when it comes to very thick armor. You can see, of course, you do have a lower plate, which is, of course, to be expected, and you do have a little hatch, which can be penetrated from time to time, but when you use this tank effectively and really use that armor, it actually becomes a very, very well-armored beast. You can see if we look at the turret, it is very thick basically everywhere, and even the upper plate is actually really thick, which is actually the first time in the E5 line that we really see a good solid upper plate that isn't as susceptible to being penetrated as easily as some others. Now, of course, it's not impenetrable, but it still does a very good job, especially if you angle it up. Now, of course, just like with the previous tanks, this is very good at hold down. Your 10 degrees of gun depression can really help you to enhance that upper plate, and of course also hide that little hatch that you have. Now, you do technically have that little green area on the upper plate, but overall, if you hide that as well, this tank becomes basically impenetrable by anyone that's not got a super, super high penetration. Now, a lot like the T29, this tank isn't the best of side scrapers. When you go at an angle of about 20 degrees, pretty much everything goes in, with maybe the exception of a heat shell that gets sucked into the tracks, but for the most part, it's pretty weak. Now, you can angle it a little bit, you can get to about 15, 17 degrees if you're really lucky, and you can still bounce some shells, and it can definitely work in a pinch, you can definitely bounce off of it, but it's definitely not your go-to position when it comes to this tank. It is very much a hold-down tank, and it is very, very focused on that. But anyway, that is the armor. Now let's look at the other characteristics about the tank, because the armor, honestly, is not the only thing good about the T32. Now, looking at the tank's characteristics with 100% crew and no kind of provisions or equipment or anything like that, it's really solid, honestly. Its hit point pool is sitting at 1,850, which ranks it 4 out of 42 when it comes to tier 8 heavy tanks, which is really good. As well, you do have 250 meters of view range, which ranks you at top 2 when it comes to tier 8 heavies, and it's actually very nice. You can definitely spot up some of the enemy heavies before they spot you up, which really gives you an advantage of being able to just see them sooner, especially if you're in a really close clutch game where you're kind of having to go against one or maybe two enemies. Just being able to spot them that tiny little bit before they spot you is very, very helpful. Now, your damage per minute is not the most. It ranks about 21 out of 42, so it's really right there, right in the middle of the road, sitting at 1,900 base damage per minute for your AP rounds. Now, your penetration also is not the most stellar. It's only 218, so that is one thing that's not so fantastic about the tank. But overall, I actually personally find I don't have much of a problem with this. And if you really do need, you can up that up to about 265 millimeters when you run APCR. But still, I find for the most part, I can hit a lot of my shells. Now, you don't have the highest alpha ever, sitting at 310, again, about middle of the road, but it definitely gets the job done. Now, unlike a lot of the previous tanks in the E5 tech tree, you don't have super fast shell velocity. I mean, for the previous tiers, it's good, but tier for tier, it's pretty low at 945 meters a second. So it's not the fastest shell ever, but it still gets the job done. Now, an interesting thing about the T32 is its dispersion. It's actually kind of bad, sitting at 0.393. For all intents and purposes, we can basically up that up to about 0.4. So that is a fairly inaccurate gun, and it's actually very close to the T1 Heavy, which is earlier in the E5 line, which I said had a very troll gun. But here's the interesting thing. I don't find this gun to be painful to use. I find that for the most part, when you're in Tier 8, you can actually not have to worry about accuracy as much in some cases because the tanks just in general are bigger. If you're in a tier 5, it's going to of course be very small and the weak spots aren't going to be great. So of course the T1 with its 0.4 accuracy is kind of lousy. But again with the T32, because I'm working with bigger tanks and running into bigger tanks and just in general the target being bigger, I really don't find that the gun trolls me all that often. Now you do have a very nice base aim time of 2.21 seconds, which of course can be improved if you run things like equipment and provisions and stuff like that. So yeah, the dispersion's not the greatest, but the base aim time really helps it to kind of not be as troll, and of course the bigger targets does help. Now you are not the fastest tank ever. Your forward speed is sitting at about 35, which is again is just about middle of the road when it comes to tier 8 heavies. So you're not screaming around the battlefield, but you're not just a slow slug either. It's kind of in between. And backward speed is about 14. Last thing I want to talk about the tank is its size. So I would say that's probably one of the downsides to this tank. It's pretty big. If you look again at the armor here, it's huge. I mean, the turret's pretty small, as you can see, and it's fairly low to the ground, but it's very wide and it's very long, so it can make a bigger target if you play it incorrectly. Of course, if you're hiding all that, it doesn't really matter. But anyway, with the statistics out of the way, I would like to show you a quick replay that really sums up this tank fairly well, in my opinion. So in this game here, I was playing on Port Bay, and as well, this was also a raiding game. Now, as we move into position, I want to go over a few things that are worth noting. Firstly, if you go and look at Blitzstars and look at the player count, you can see across all the servers, it does say that this tank has 10,000 players, which sounds like a lot, but personally, when I'm playing, I usually don't see too many people running this tank, and oddly enough, when I do, it's often a better player, I will say. But the weird thing, and this is really bizarre, the day that I was playing this tank, in fact, the day I was playing this replay, I actually played about 11 games in ratings, and I got 5 class 1s. And honestly, I am nowhere near that good of a player, so that is telling me that there are definitely a lot of people who are playing this tank and are really struggling. So I guess it has something to do with the hold down. You can see there, it's not always the easiest to play. You can see I'm still not able to get too many shots down right there just because it is a pretty steep slope. But in general, I find this tank, when played in a hold down position like this, even if you're not necessarily able to get shots off super, super quick and do like 5,000 damage, it's very solid and has definitely helped me with some very clutch wins in the past. Now we are focusing on the Yo back there because I can see he's definitely pushing on to my mediums, which we really don't want because he does have the clip and the hit points that he could theoretically actually push through and really wreak havoc over there. So I'm trying not to ignore him while at the same time not ignoring these heavies or the TDs in the back. Now, interesting shot there. Basically, you just have to wait till they show their weak spot. And again, most tanks actually have some pretty big weak spots. It's just about knowing where to penetrate them and trying to be as accurate as you can with your shots. Now, unfortunately, the Yo did clear the Brasque over there, and we do need to be careful because our Lorraine is definitely getting focused. Now, funny thing here, when I shot this shell, my teammate actually cleared him out, so it did look pretty funny. Took me a second to realize that I wasn't the one that killed him, but I quickly move on. Now, we're focusing on these TDs in the back, again, just waiting for them to show their sides, and here comes the Batshat for a quick flank. We do get a nice bounce there, which was really cool, and he shoots my teammate, so I know it's okay to push. We get one shot into him. We can't block the shark here, so I'm trying to stay out of his way so that he can get in a shot, and then I will try to get in another one, but the Batshat ends up pulling back. Now, we're in a bit of a sticky position here because we've got tanks both pushing on our right and our left, as you can see there. So I get a quick shot into the Batshat, and then I see that my friendly shark is pushing towards the OBJ, and rather than leave him there and potentially risk him dying, I decide to support him while trying not to block him too much, and I go ahead and get a kill on the OBJ before he can clear out our T-5042. Now, you can see the base capture points. They're definitely going up very fast. They had someone go and capture A and B, so it is very, very close. We do get a nice shot onto the WZ, making sure to load APCR so that we do manage to penetrate. And then here's the Brask. So it actually took me a few seconds to clear him out, but thankfully we were able to get him in the end, and it's getting very, very close on base capture points. Honestly, we could probably afford to miss one, maybe two shots, but really you want to be as accurate as possible. We get one shot, and then we get bounced off of, and then our teammate clears it out, and not only leaving us with a nice class one, but a very nice victory, which really boosts my rating as well. And yeah, that is the T32. It's not one that you necessarily think of as OP, but it's really good. If you really give it a chance, it can be very, very solid at what it does. The hold down positioning, the thick armor, it's just phenomenal. But anyway, that is the T32, and I hope to be doing a review on the M103 fairly soon. But anyway, with that, I hope y'all enjoyed, and as always, have fun, good luck, and happy tanking.